So the Joint Staff, what's its deal? It derives its authority, to the extent that it has any, from Title 10 of the U.S. Code, and particularly from the enumeration of the responsibilities of the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. And there are a bunch, but probably the central one from my vantage point, which, as I'll talk to in a minute, was in the J5, or the Strategy Plans and Policy Directorate, was that the by statute, the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff is the principal military advisor to the President, the Secretary of Defense, and the National Security Council. So that was a lot of what we did, was help the chairman formulate military advice related to strategy, plans, policy, so he could provide that advice. That involved working with the National Security Council, the Office of the Secretary of Defense, the Uniformed Services, the Combatant Commands, the Intelligence Community, the National Nuclear Security Administration, the State Department, and a whole bunch of other people who find me really quite insufferably annoying. Because I was always that guy who would tell them why they were wrong and then have the footnotes to back it up. One thing I'll note about the chairman is advice is not command. So even though the Secretary of Defense and the President issue orders typically through the chairman to the combatant commanders who are responsible for the operational military forces, the chairman doesn't tell them what to do. Lordy, would they let me know that. And also, he doesn't tell the services how to spend money to organize, train, and equip military equipment. So the senior most military officer in the country neither gives operational commands, though he may transmit them, nor does he tell services what to buy. It kind of sounds like a lame job, doesn't it, right? You don't control money or people or combat forces. But in fact, the power, as I'll talk to in a minute, is really about that military advice and influence. The nature of that advice has changed over time, but it gives you a lot of influence in the sense that you get to communicate the senior most military officer's advice on behalf of the Joint Chiefs, on behalf of the combatant commanders, to the Secretary of Defense and the President, and through the National Security Council process. So it's an important position, it's an influential position, but it is an influence position, not a command position. I'm happy to talk more about that distinction.